Hello, we're going to go through getting started with TimeGPT. You are in your dashboard at this API key management place, and that is the right place to be. So the first thing we're going to do is we are going to create an API key. And we are going to copy that key. Now I'm going to use that key in my code for doing a forecast. I'm going to use Jupyter Notebooks and Python, but you could use Python or R, any other language that you want to use to access our API. So the first thing that we're going to do is we are going to install Nixla. Actually, I already installed it, so you see that all came through. And now what we're going to do is instantiate the Nixla client class with your API key and validate that key. So that key that I just generated, I'm going to copy it in here, and then here's my Nixla client, and then that validate API key just shows that that's working. That's true. We are all set to go. So now we're going to do an example with the air passengers data. So I am going to load in that data. We can see here that we have a timestamp and a value. So the timestamp is the time and the value is what we have and what we want to make predictions on. So we're going to make our forecast. We use this forecast function. Our data frame is DF. H equals 12, that's H is horizon. So we are predicting 12 steps in the future. Then the frequency here is monthly. So we set that as monthly. Then the time column is that timestamp column. And then what we want to make predictions on is that value. So we are going to run that and then take a look at the output. These are our future predictions. And just like that, we've made a forecast. So let's plot that out using the Nixla client plot function. And so we can see we have our historical data and our plotted data here. So we can visualize our forecast as well. This gets you started. You can find this information in our quick start guide, along with extensive documentation on a lot of the other features that you can use within TimeGPT forecasting. Happy forecasting!